My story with Sulmona began very, very recently. My father had been captured in North Africa in 1941, and he was transferred to Italy to be a prisoner of war in Sulmona. However, I wasn't really aware of that until I found his notes. I then went on the internet to find out if there were any remnants of, at the prison camp, or if there was anyone who could show me where it was so I could visit. When I made the query, the Welcome to Sulmona sign came up, and they suggested I contact Gabri Di Mattia. Gabri and I have had a lot of emails and Facebook exchanges, and I learned so much more about the camp, and it's just amazing to be in Sulmona such a short time later. When we arrived in Sulmona, we came the long way. We didn't come on the autostrada, and the mountains in the distance were so amazing. And just the thought that my dad, nearly 70 years ago, had looked at those same mountains. When we drove into Sulmona, it was just magic. It's the most beautiful little town. In Australia, we only have a history of 227 years. You have thousands of years of history here. And it's just amazing to go around and see the old buildings, the palaces, the piazza, and just the glorious history of the place. It's a beautiful, beautiful city. I love it dearly, and I look forward to coming back. Gabri is an amazing ambassador for Sulmona. She arranged that I would be received by the Vice Mayor. Then I have met many important people in the city. We went up to have a look at the Abbey, and while we were at the Abbey, I met the Governor. But that was an honour to meet the Vice Mayor, to meet the other people that I've met in Sulmona, and to meet the Governor is just a total honour and a pleasure for me. It's very important. My father was always going to write a book. He said he had enough information to write a book about his time as a prisoner in Italy. He was then transferred to Germany after the 8th of September 1943, and was in various work camps in Germany and what is now part of Poland. Unfortunately, he was killed when he was 57. He had planned a trip to return to the area and retrace his steps. At the end of the war, he was also part of the Long March to Freedom, which is also known as the Death March. And he wanted to come back and go through Italy and Germany and Poland where he'd been. He was killed in a car accident in 1968, which is 47 years ago. And now at the age of 61, close to when he wanted to travel to come, I have decided to come and retrace his journey through Europe where he was. I'm in the process of writing a book of his story. Although he said he had enough information to write a book, most of it was in his head. However, now with the internet and various other publications, all the information is out there, and it's a matter of just collating it and piecing it together with exactly my father's footsteps and my father's journey. Oh, they were so pleased. For many years, they have said to me, "Have you started Granddad's story?" And I'd say, "Not yet, I'm too busy." And in 2002, I sat down to start the story. And 13 years later, I hadn't gone any further. When I did start to research it a few months ago, I said to my daughter, this story is so big, I don't know that I can do it. There is so much information out there, I'm not sure that I can have the time to finish this. My granddaughter, who was 12, said to me, Grandma Susie, you have to write this book about Granddad Doug, because if you don't write this book, when I have great-grandchildren, I won't be able to tell them the story. But they are so supportive, so happy that I'm here, and Zulmona is like the first step of the journey, and they are just so happy that I'm here to do this and have it recorded for our own family history, but also for other members of the battalion that he was in, because the ones that were captured on that day, on the 7th of April 1941 in Libya and North Africa, their stories are all very similar. There were 160 people captured on that day, and each one of those stories is very similar. So it's recording it for all them as well. I think it's also important too for the people of Zulmona to know the story from an Australian soldier's point of view. I think for many years they believed that there were only English in the camp, and that would have simply come because the Australians are mostly descended from the English and they spoke English. So they didn't diversify between British and Australian and New Zealand. They were just all considered English. I would recommend to all Australians to come. If they have a father who was in the prison camp, I think I'm a member of a Facebook page called the 2nd 15th Battalion, and they are all, the people in that battalion are the ones that were captured on that day with my father. So I now have access to people that fought with him, fought alongside him, and were captured with him. Not to those people, unfortunately, because they've passed away now, but so many of their family members are interested, and some of them have already made the trip to Zulmona. I think they came here a few years ago and didn't have access to the site, and now with the likes of the Tourist Information Centre here and Gabri and many others, there's been a huge reawakening of life at that time. And like I said before, with having the information on the internet, it makes it so much easier for people to come here and find the story. So I will also recommend Zulmona as a tourist destination, regardless of whether they have any connection with Campo Seta Otto or whether they don't. It is just the prettiest little town and beautifully set in the mountains, and I think everyone should have Zulmona on their list to visit.